song of Moses. Give ear, O ye heavens, and I will speak, and let me speak while I speak, and hear, O earth, the words of my mouth, and let the earth hear the words of my mouth. Let earth listen to my lips. My doctrine shall drop as the rain. May my discourse come down as the rain. May my instruction soak in like the rain. My speech shall distill as the dew. Let my speech distill as the dew. As the small rain upon the tender earth, like mist on the green growth, as the mist on the fresh grass, as copious rains on tender grass, like a downpour upon the grass, and as the showers upon the grass, like droplets on the grass, and light rain on the turf. Because I will publish the name of the Lord, for I will proclaim the name of Jehovah. For the name of the Lord I will proclaim, for I will sing the Lord's renown. I will proclaim the greatness of the Lord. Ascribe ye greatness unto our God. O tell the greatness of our God. He is the rock. His work is perfect. The rock, his work is perfect. The rock, his deeds are perfect. For he is a rock. What he does is right, for all his ways are judgment. A God of truth and without iniquity, just and right is he. A God of faithfulness, a God trusty and holy, true, right and fair is he. They have corrupted themselves, their spot is not the spot of his children. They have dealt corruptly with them, they are not his children. It is their blemish. They have dealt corruptly with him. They are no longer his children because of their blemish. His sons' sons have depraved themselves. To him they prove untrue. But Israel has become corrupt, smeared with sin. They are no longer his. His unregenerate offspring have dealt corruptly toward him. They have sinned. Blemished children are not his. They are a perverse and crooked generation, a shifty, crafty crew, a deceitful and underhand brood, a generation twisted and crooked. Do ye thus requite the Lord, O foolish people and unwise? It is Yahweh ye thus requite. Is this your answer to the Lord, you foolish and senseless people? Is not he thy father that hath bought thee? Is not this your father who gave you being? Hath he not made thee and established thee? He hath made thee and established thee. Who made you and fashioned you? Fashioned you and made you endure. Remember the days of old. Consider the years of many generations. Think back on the days of old. Review the years, age after age. Ask thy father and he will show thee. Thy elders and they will tell thee. When the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance, when he separated the sons of Adam, when he separated the children of men, when he spread abroad the sons of Adam, when he parceled out the descendants of Adam, when he made divisions among mankind, he set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel. He had the limits of the peoples marked out, keeping in mind the number of the children of Israel. He fixed the boundaries of peoples in relation to Israel's numbers, according to the number of the sons of God, each with its guardian angel. He assigned the realms of the nations to the various deities. He laid down the boundaries of every people according to the number of the sons of God. When God divided up the world among the nations, he gave each of them a supervising angel. For the Lord's portion is his people, Jacob is the lot of his inheritance. Jacob, his inherited possession. But Jacob became the eternal share, Israel his very own. While the Lord's apportionment was his own people, Jacob was the allotment for him to hold, but Yahweh's portion was his people, Jacob his share of inheritance. He found him in a desert land, and in the waste howling wilderness, and in the howling waste of the wilderness, and in a void, a howling wilderness, in an empty howling waste. He led him about, he instructed him, He protected him, cared for him, circled round them, cared for them. He protects him, rears him. He kept him as the apple of his eye, shielded him as the pupil of his own eye. As an eagle stirreth up her nest, fluttereth over her young, that stirreth up, that fluttereth, as an eagle incites its nestlings forth, by hovering over its brood, dashing against its brood, spreadeth abroad her wings, taketh them, beareth them on her wings. He spread abroad his wings, he took them, he beareth them on his pinions. Spreadeth abroad his wings, taketh one, beareth it up on his pinions, spreading its wings to catch them, and bearing them on its pinions. So the Lord alone did lead him, and there was no strange God with him. Jehovah alone did lead him, and there was no foreign God with him. So the Lord alone was guide to them. He made him ride on the high places of the earth, that he might eat the increase of the fields. And he did eat the increase of the field. He had them ride triumphant over the summits of the land. He made them masters of the highlands, living off the hills. And afterwards he settled them in a country of high hills, and fed them with the produce of the field. And he made them to suck honey out of the rock, and oil out of the flinty rock, giving them honey to suck from its rocks, and olive oil from its hard, stony ground, sucking honey from the very crags, and oil from the flinty rocks. Honey oozed from its rocks. On its barren uplands, the olive could flourish. Butter of kine and milk of sheep, butter of the herd and milk of the flock, curds from cows and milk from sheep, the fat of lambs and rams of the breed of Bashan and goats. With the fattest of lambs and rams, young bulls and goats. With the fat of lambs and rams, herds of Bashan and goats. With the best of lambs and rams, bulls of Bashan and he-goats. With the fat of kidneys of wheat, with the finest of the wheat, with the very choicest of the wheat, rich food of the wheat's ear. And thou didst drink the pure blood of the grape, and the blood of the grape thou didst drink as it foamed. With the grape's blood you drank it foaming. They drank the sparkling wine. But Jeshurun waxed fat and kicked. When Jacob had eaten and was filled, then he who was beloved began to kick. Jacob ate and had his fill. Jeshurun grew fat, turned restive. So Jacob ate his fill. The darling grew fat and frisky. Thou art waxen fat. Thou art grown thick. Thou art covered with fatness. Thou art become sleek. Yes, you grew fat, became plump and sleek. You grew fat, gross, bloated. Then he forsook God which made him, and lightly esteemed the rock of his salvation, and treated as foolish his rock of salvation. They forsook that divine creator, revolted against their deliverer, scorned the steadfast one, their succor. They shrugged away the rock of their salvation. They provoked him to jealousy with strange gods. They incensed them with alien things. With abominations provoked they him to anger, angered him with hateful idols. They sacrificed unto devils, not to God. They sacrificed unto demons, which were no God. They sacrificed to foreign demons that are no gods, to God whom they knew not, to new gods that came newly up, whom your fathers feared not. To new gods that came up of late, to newcomers just arrived, of whom their fathers had never stood in awe, whom your fathers had never dreaded. Of the rock that begot thee, thou art unmindful, and hast forgotten God that formed thee. Thou wast unmindful, you forsook the Creator, who begot you and cared nothing for God, who brought you to birth. What? Forsake the sheltering power that gave thee birth? Forget the very Lord who created thee? And when the Lord saw it, he abhorred them because of the provoking of his sons and of his daughters. The Lord saw it and spurned them. When the Lord saw this, he was filled with loathing and anger towards. And he said, I will hide my face from them. I will see what their end shall be, and see how they fare in the end, and show what shall befall them in the latter days. For they are a very froward generation, children in whom is no faith. For a generation given to intrigue they are, children in whom is no faithfulness. For a fickle race are they, children in whom there is no sense of honor. Sons with no loyalty in them, for they are a mutinous generation. They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not God. They have provoked me to anger with their vanities. They roused my jealousy with a God of no account, vexed me with their futilities. Phantoms have been my rivals. And I will move them to jealousy with those which are not a people. I therefore will move them to jealousy with a no people, with a people of no account, with a worthless people. I'll incense them with a no folk. I will provoke them to anger with a foolish nation. With an impious people I will vex them. I will anger them with an empty-headed nation. For a fire is kindled in mine anger, and shall burn unto the lowest hell, and burns to the deepest Sheol, and shall burn as far as Hades beneath, and it blazes to the depths of the underworld, flaming to the netherworld itself, and shall consume the earth with her increase, and set on fire the foundations of the mountains, consuming the earth with its yields, and licking with flames the roots of the mountains. I will heap mischiefs upon them. I will spend mine arrows upon them. I will heap evils upon them. I will heap on them one disaster after another. I will hurl disasters upon them, and shoot all my arrows against them, and shoot them down with my arrows. They shall be burnt with hunger, and devoured with burning heat. And with bitter destruction, they shall be wasted with hunger, wasted by famine. They shall be devoured by burning fever and deadly pestilence. For weapons, I shall have barns of famine, fever and consumption for poison. I will also send the teeth of beasts upon them with the poison of serpents of the dust, with the poison of crawling things of the dust, and fanged beasts will I let loose against them, with venomous creepers in the dust. I will harry them with the fangs of wild beasts, and the poison of creatures that crawl in the dust. The sword without and terror within shall destroy both the young man and the virgin. Without shall the sword bereave, and in the chambers terror. It shall destroy both young man and virgin. Outdoors, the sword shall bereave them. Indoors, it will be terror for both the young man and the maid. In the open death by the sword, inside the house, a panic for youths and girls alike. Outside the enemy's sword, inside the plate, the suckling also with the man of gray hairs, the baby at the breast, and the gray-haired man. I said, I would scatter them into corners. I said, I would scatter them afar. I might have said, I will blow them away. I would have said, I would scatter them afar. I would have said, I would cut them in pieces. I had meant to finish them off. I would make the remembrance of them to cease from among men. Were it not that I feared the wrath of the enemy, the taunt of the foe I feared, had I not feared the insolence of their enemies, lest their adversaries should behave themselves strangely, lest their enemies should judge amiss, lest their foes should misinterpret it, and lest they should say, our hand is high, and the Lord hath not done all this, declaring it was our hand that hath triumphed, and not the Lord who has done all this. Yahweh plays no part in this. For they are a nation void of counsel, neither is there any understanding in them. For a nation of vanished sagacity they are, perpetuous folk are the folk devoid of all sense. How lost to right judgment is people of Israel. Oh, that they were wise, that they understood this, that they would consider their latter end. If they were wise, they would understand this, they would discern their latter end. They would see their own fates at the end. They would be able to read their destiny. How should one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight? How could one chase? How could one man ride 1,000? Except their rock had sold them, and the Lord had shut them up. Unless their rock had sold them, and Yahweh had abandoned them. For the rock is not as our rock, even our enemies themselves being judges. For the enemy hath no rock like ours. In themselves, they are mere fools. Our fools themselves so concluding. For their vine is of the vine of Sodom, and their vine comes from the stock of Sodom, and of the fields of Gomorrah, from the vineyards of Gomorrah, grown on the terraces of Gomorrah. Their grapes are grapes of gall, their clusters are bitter, their grapes are poisonous berries, their clusters are envenomed, a bitter growth their clusters, their wine is the poison of dragons, and the cruel venom of asps is the poison of serpents, and the pitiless poison of cobras. Is not this laid up in store with me, and sealed up among my treasures? Have I not stored up this their guilt? Do I not hold it in reserve for them? But he, is he not something precious to me, sealed inside my treasury? But Israel is my special people, sealed as jewels within my treasury. To me belongeth vengeance and recompense. Vengeance is mine and recompense. Unto the days of vengeance and requital, against the day of revenge and requital, to the day of punishment and vengeance. Their foot shall slide in due time, at the time when their foot shall slide, against the time that their foot slips, against the time they lose their footing. For the day of their calamity is at hand, and the things that shall come upon them make haste. For near is the day of their fate, and destiny rushes upon them. For the Lord shall judge his people and repent himself for his servants. For Yahweh will vindicate his people. The Lord will see his people righted, and for his servants he will show compassion. When he sees that their power is gone, and there is none shut up or left, and there is none remaining shut up or left at large, when he sees them powerless, dispeopled to a man, and their protected and unprotected alike disappearing, and that both bond and free are no more, for he will see that their strength is gone, alone or defended by his clan, no one is left, and he shall say, where are their gods, their rock in whom they took refuge? Their rock in which they took refuge, whom they relied on as their rock, the rocks they claimed to be their refuge, which did eat the fat of their sacrifices and drank the wine of their drink offerings, who ate fat slices of their sacrifices and drank their libation wine. Let them rise up and help you, and be your protection, and let them be a shelter over you. See now that I, even I am he, see then that I am he, see now that I am he that is. Ah, learn that I am the real God, and there is no God with me, no God beside me. I kill and I make alive, I wound and I heal, I have wounded and I heal. Mine is the power of death and life, neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand, and from my hand there is no rescue. For I lift up my hand to heaven and say, I live forever, and say, as I live forever, and swear, as I live forever, and vow by my existence, if I wet my glittering sword, and mine hand take hold on judgment, when I wet my flashing blade, I will take up the cause of right, and my hand take hold on justice, gripping justice by the hilt. I will render vengeance to mine enemies, and will reward them that hate me. Glory! I will wreak vengeance on my foes. I will make mine arrows drunk with blood. My sword shall devour flesh. I will inebriate my arrows with blood. I drench my arrows in their blood. My blade devours their bodies, and that with the blood of the slain and of the captives from the beginning of the revenges upon the enemy. With the blood of the slain and the captives, from the head of the leaders of the enemy, blood of the slain and the captive, from the long-haired enemy chiefs, blood of the slain and prisoners, braves with flowing locks, blood of slain and captives, the heads of the enemy princes. Rejoice, O ye nations, with his people. Praise his people, O you nations. Praise his people, O Gentile nations. Shout among the nations, O you his people. Rejoice, O heavens, with them, and let all the angels of God worship him. Rejoice, O nations, with his people, and let all the children of God rely on him. Heavens, rejoice with him. Let the sons of God pay him homage. Nations, rejoice with his people, for he will avenge the blood of his servants, and will render vengeance to his adversaries, and will be merciful unto his land and to his people, and will give absolution to his land and to his people, and is propitious unto the soil of his people, and purge his people's land of guilt. And Moses came and spake all the words of this song in the ears of the people, he and Hoshea the son of Nun, and recited all the words of this song in the hearing of the people, he and Joshua the son of Nun. And Moses made an end of speaking all these words to all Israel. And he said unto them, set your hearts unto all the words which I testify among you this day. Apply your hearts unto all the words. Take to heart all the warnings which I have now given you, which ye shall command your children to observe to do. All the words of this law, which ye shall command your children to observe to do, all the words of this law, and join them upon your children, that they may observe faithfully all the terms of this teaching. For it is not a vain thing for you, because it is your life. For this is no trivial matter for you, rather it means your very life. It is no idle thing you will be doing, for the law is your life. And through this thing ye shall prolong your days in the land, whither ye go over Jordan to possess it, and by its means you will live long in the land. Through it ye shall long endure on the land. And the Lord spake unto Moses that selfsame day, saying, get thee up into the mountain Abram, unto Mount Nebo, which is in the land of Moab, that is over against Jericho. Ascend this mountain of the Abram, Mount Nebo, which is in the land of Moab, opposite Jericho. Ascend these heights of Abram to Mount Nebo, which is in the land of Moab, facing Jericho. Go up on the Mount Nebo, here in the Abram Mountains, it is in the land of Moab, facing Jericho, and behold, the land of Canaan, which I give unto the children of Israel for a possession. And view the land of Canaan, which I am giving the Israelites for their very own. And die in the mount whither thou goest up, and be gathered unto thy people. Die on the mountain you have climbed. Ha! Then you shall die on the mountain you have climbed, and shall be taken to your people. On that mountain thou art to die. This height climbed, thou must needs become a part of thy people. As Aaron thy brother died in Mount Hor, and was gathered unto his people, and was gathered to his fathers, and was gathered to his father's king, because he trespassed against me among the children of Israel, at the waters of Meribah Kadesh, in the wilderness of Sin. For you both broke faith with me among the Israelite people. You disobeyed me in full sight of the whole people at the water of rebellion in the desert of Sin, because he sanctified me not in the midst of the children of Israel. When you failed to honor me among the Israelites by failing to uphold my sanctity among the Israelite people, because you did not display my holiness among the sons of Israel. Yet thou shalt see the land before thee, but thou shalt not go thither unto the land which I give the children of Israel. For thou shalt see the land before thee, the land you may view from afar. Accordingly you shall view the land from a point of vantage, but you shall not enter. You may view the land from a distance. And this is the blessing wherewith Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death, with which Moses, the man of God, bade the Israelites farewell before he died, which Moses, the man of God, pronounced upon the people of Israel before his death. And he said, the Lord came from Sinai and rose up from Seir unto them, Yahweh from Sinai came near. Yea, he done, out of Seir upon them. For them after Seir he rose on the horizon. He shined forth from Mount Paran, and he came with 10,000s of saints. He shone forth from the mountains of Paran, from Paran's range, he rayed out, and he came from the 10,000s of holy ones, surrounded by 10,000s of holy angels, and came from holy myriads, and approached from Ribioth Kadesh. And for them he came after the mustering at Kadesh. From his right hand went a fiery law for them, and his right hand was a fiery law for them, with flaming fire. At his right hand, lightning flashing at them from his right, blazing in fire from the south, with his lightning bolts at his right hand. Out of his hand proceeded fire to guide them. Yeah, he loved the people. All his saints are in thy hand. Yeah, he loved the people. Yeah, he loves the peoples. Woo! Yeah! He loved his people, lover indeed of the people. Yeah, he loved the tribes. All those consecrated to him were in his hand. All those consecrated to him he blesses and holds safe their sacred host. In your hand are all the holy ones, and they sat down at thy feet. Everyone shall receive of thy words. So they recline at thy feet. Each one bear away some of thy words. Moses commanded us a law. A law did Moses command us, even the inheritance of the congregation of Jacob. An inheritance for the assembly of Jacob, he made the community of Jacob his domain. And he was king in Jeshurun. And he became king in Jeshurun. And he became king of his darling. Thus the Lord became king in Jeshurun. Then a king arose in Jeshurun. When the heads of the people and the tribes of Israel were gathered together, when the heads of the people were gathered, all the tribes of Israel together, elected by a convocation of the leaders of the tribes, as one man the tribes of Israel. Let Reuben live and not die, and not die out. And let not his men be few, nor let his men be few. Let his men be few, yet never a growing populace. And this is a blessing of Judah. And he said, Hear, Lord, the voice of Judah, and bring him unto his people, and bring him in unto his people, and restore him to his people, and bring him back to his people. Let his hands be sufficient for him, and be thou in help to him from his enemies. With his hands he contended for himself, though his own hands strive for him, help him against his foes. His own hands defend his cause, and you will be his help against his foes. Glory! And of Levi he said, Let thy Thummim and thy Urim be with thy Holy One. Thy Thummim and thy Urim are with thy Godly One. Give thy Thummim to Levi, and thy Urim to the man devoted to thee. Give thine oracles to Levi, to thy man of favor. Let your perfections and your lights belong unto thy man of loving kindness, whom thou didst prove at Massah, and with whom thou didst strive at the waters of Meribah, whom thou didst test at Massah, and with whom thou didst strive at the waters of Meribah, who said unto his father and to his mother, I have not seen him, and who said of his father and of his mother, I have not seen him, I do not regard them, neither did he acknowledge his brethren, nor knew his own children. His brothers he would not acknowledge, and his own children he refused to recognize. His brothers too he disavowed and ignored, as well as his own children, for they have observed thy word, and kept thy covenant, and keep thy covenant. Yes, they have kept your word, they hold firmly to your covenant, paying heed rather to thy warnings, keeping true to thy covenant. They shall teach Jacob thy judgments, and Israel thy law. He communicates thy ordinances to Jacob, they promulgate your decisions to Jacob and your law to Israel. They shall put incense before thee and all burnt sacrifice upon thine altar and all burnt offering. They shall offer you incense to savor. They put perfume in your nose. Bless, Lord, his substance and accept the work of his hands. O Lord, bless his might and favor his undertakings. Yahweh, bless his worthiness. Smite through the loins of them that rise against him. Crush thou the loins of them who prick the backs of his adversaries, and of them that hate him, that they rise not again. Disable his opponents past opposing. And of Benjamin he said, the beloved of the Lord shall dwell in safety by him. He is the beloved of the Lord, and dwells beside him securely. He is the eternal's darling. And the Lord shall cover him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders. He covereth him all the day long, and he dwelleth between his shoulders. The high God shields him all the day long, and he dwells under his protection. The Lord encircles him perpetually and makes his dwelling place between his shoulders. The Most High encircles him, seated upon his slopes, and dwells between his hillsides. And of Joseph he said, blessed of the Lord be his land. Blessed by the Lord be his land for the precious things of heaven, for the precious stores of the skies, with the wealth of the heavens above, for the dew and for the deep that couches beneath. For him the best of heaven's dew, and of the deep that lies below, with the choice gifts of heaven above, and of the deep that couches beneath, with the bounty of dew from heaven. And for the precious gifts, and for the precious fruits brought by the sun, of the fruits of the sun, with wealth of crops from the sunlight, with the best of what the sun makes grow, and for the precious things put forth by the moon, of the growth of the moons, and the rich yield of the months, with wealth of produce month by month, and for the chief things of the ancient mountains, and for the highest blessings of the ancient mountains. Choice produce let there be on the ancient mountains, and for the precious things of the lasting hills, and the bounty of the hills in the morning, and the best from the timeless hills, and for the precious things of the earth and fullness thereof, and the fullness thereof, the best of the land and all it holds, and for the goodwill of him that dwelt in the bush, and with the goodwill of one who dwelt in a thorn bush, and the acceptance of him who shekineth in the bush, and the favor of the presence in the bush. Let the blessing come upon the head of Joseph, and upon the top of the head of him that was separated from his brethren, and upon the crown of the head of him that was separate, and upon the crown of the head of him that is prince among his brethren. May it all descend on Joseph, the prince of his brothers, and upon the brow of the prince among his brothers, and on the brow of him who was cursed by his brothers. His glory is like the firstling of his bullock, his firstling of his herd. Majesty is his, as his firstling bull may majesty be his. And his horns are like the horns of unicorns, and his horns are the horns of the wild ox. And the horns of a buffalo be his horns, and his horns are the horns of a ram. He is a young bull in strength and splendor, with the strong bull, with the strong horns of a wild ox. With them he shall push the peoples together to the ends of the earth. With them he shall push the peoples, all of them, to the ends of the earth, to gore the nations, all of them, even to the far end of earth, to butt the nations with them and drive them to the ends of the earth. And they are the 10,000s of Ephraim, and they are the thousands of Manasseh. Such are the myriads of Ephraim. Such too are the thousands of Manasseh. And of Zebulun, he said, rejoice, Zebulun, in thy going out, and Issachar, in thy tents. Rejoice, Zebulun, in your enterprises abroad. Prosper, Zebulun, in your voyages abroad. Rejoice, O Zebulun, you outdoorsmen, and you, Issachar, in your tents at home. They shall call the people unto the mountain. There they shall offer sacrifices of righteousness. They shall call the peoples. Peoples shall be their guests on the mountain height, where their solemn sacrifice is offered. You who invite the tribes to the mountains, where feasts are duly held. They call peoples to their mountain shrines. There they offer the prescribed sacrifices. For they shall suck of the abundance of the seas, and of treasures hid in the sand. For they suck the affluence of the seas, and the hidden treasures of the sand, and draw out the hidden wealth of the sand. Wow! And of Gad, he said, blessed be he that enlargeth Gad. Blessed be he who gives Gad space enough. Blessed be he who has made Gad so vast. He dwelleth as a lion, and teareth, roar, the arm with the crown of the head. He dwelleth as a lioness, and teareth the arm, yea, the crown of the head. He has savaged arm and face and head. Poised is he like a lion to tear off arm and scalp. And he provided the first part for himself. He chose the best of the land. And he chose the best of the land for himself. He saw that the best should be his, because there in a portion of the lawgiver was he seated. Glory! For there was the lawgiver's portion reserved. For there a commander's portion was reserved. For there was the portion of an honored leader. And he came with the heads of the people. He executed the justice of the Lord and his judgments with Israel. He was in the van of the people to fulfill the Lord's design and his decisions for Israel. He went with the chiefs of the nations and did the righteous will of the Lord, Israel. He executed his judgments for Israel. And of Dan, he said, Dan is a lion's whelp. He shall leap from Bashan, that leapeth forth from Bashan, that makes his spring from Bashan. And of Naphtali, he said, oh, Naphtali, satisfied with favor and full with the blessing of the Lord. O Naphtali, loaded with favors, possess thou the west and the south. The lake and the south are his possession. Shall hold the lake of Kinnereth and the south. The west and the sunny south do thou possess. Take possession of the lake and the south. The Mediterranean coast and the Negev are your home. And of Asher, he said, let Asher be blessed with children. Blessed be Asher with children. Blessed above sons be Asher. Most blessed of sons be Asher. Let him be acceptable to his brethren, and let him dip his foot in oil. Let him get, let him have the goodwill of his brethren. May he be the favorite among his brothers. Let him be privileged among his brothers, rich in his olive trees. Let him have abundance of oil, as the oil of his olive trees runs over his feet. Thy shoes shall be iron and brass. Iron and bronze be thy sandals. Thy bars shall be iron and brass. May your doorbolts be iron and copper. May your bolts of iron and of bronze. Basalt and bronze ward you from harm. And as thy days, so shall thy strength be. And as thy days, so thy capability shall be. And your strength be equal to your days, and add 5 days thy strength. There is none like unto the God of Jeshurun. There is none like unto God, O Jeshurun. There is none like the God of Israel. There is none like the God of the Beloved, who rideth upon the heaven in thy help, upon the heavens for thy help, who rides through the heavens to your help, and in his excellency on the sky, and in his majesty upon the clouds, and in his majesty through the skies. The eternal God is thy refuge. The eternal God is thy dwelling place. The God of old, he is your refuge. The ancient God, he is a refuge. The eternal God is thy home. And underneath are the everlasting arms. Here below, he is the age-old ark. The governance of God will protect thee. When under the power of everlasting arms, above is the God of aforetime, and beneath are the arms of the ages. And he shall thrust out the enemy from before thee, and shall say, destroy them. And he thrust out the enemy from before thee, and said, destroy. He shall dispossess the enemy at thy onslaught, and doom him to destruction. Israel then shall dwell in safety alone, and Israel dwelleth in safety. So Israel dwelt in safety. The fountain of Jacob shall be upon a land of corn and wine. Also, his heavens shall drop down dew, the fountain of Jacob alone, in a land of grain and new wine. Yeah, his heavens drop down dew. So Jacob lived securely. Jacob's folk were undisturbed within a land of corn and wine, under heaven's dripping dew, under heaven's dripping dew, under heaven's dripping dew. Happy art thou, O Israel, who is like unto thee, O people saved by the Lord. Happy are you, O Israel, who is like you, a people saved by the Lord. Happy are you, people of Israel, peerless, set free. How fortunate you are, O Israel. Where else is a nation victorious? In the Lord, the shield of thy help, and who is the sword of thy excellency? The shield of your help and the sword of your exaltation, your protecting shield and your sword triumphant. And thine enemies shall be found liars unto thee, and thou shalt tread upon their high places. And thine enemies shall submit themselves unto thee, so that thy foes come cringing unto thee. Your enemies will try to corrupt you, but you yourself shall trample on their backs. Your enemies shall bow low before you, and you shall trample on their backs. And Moses went up from the plains of Moab unto the mountain of Nebo, to the top of Pisgah, that is over against Jericho. From the steps of Moab, Moses ascended Mount Nebo, the headland of Pisgah, which faces Jericho. And the Lord showed him all the land of Gilead unto Dan. And the Lord showed him the whole land, Gilead as far as Dan, and all Naphtali, and the land of Ephraim and Manasseh, and all the land of Judah unto the utmost sea, unto the hinder sea, as far as the western sea, as far as the Mediterranean. Woo-hoo! And the south, and the plain of the valley of Jericho, and the city of palm trees, unto Zoar, and the south, the Negev, and the basin or valley of Jericho, the city of palms, as far as Zoar. The Negev and the stretch of the valley of Jericho, the Negev and the plain, the valley of Jericho, the vale of palm trees, as far as Zoar. And the Lord said unto him, this is the land which I swear unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, saying, I will give it unto thy seed, saying, I will give it to your descendants. I have caused thee to see it with thine eyes, but thou shalt not go over thither. I have, let you look upon it, but you shall not go over there. I have let you feast your eyes upon it. So Moses, the servant of the Lord, died there in the land of Moab, according to the word of the Lord, at the command of the Lord. And he buried him in a valley in the land of Moab, over against Beth-peor, opposite Beth-peor. But no man knoweth of his sepulchre unto this day. But to this day no one knows the place of his burial. But to this day no one has ever found his grave. And Moses was 120 years old when he died. His eye was not dim, nor his natural force abated. His eye undimmed, his vigor unimpaired. But his eye was not dim, nor the skin of his cheeks wrinkled, nor had his freshness fled, and his teeth stood firm. And the children of Israel wept for Moses in the plains of Moab 30 days. So the days of weeping and mourning for Moses were ended. So they fulfilled the days of weeping in the mourning for Moses, which completed the period of weeping in the mourning for Moses. And Joshua, the son of Nun, was full of the spirit of wisdom. Spirit of wisdom. For Moses had laid his hands upon him, and the children of Israel hearkened unto him, and did as the Lord commanded Moses. And there arose not a prophet since in Israel like unto Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face. And there hath not arisen a prophet, there hath never yet risen in Israel a prophet like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face, whom the Lord singled out face to face, with whom the Lord held converse face to face, in all the signs and in all the wonders which the Lord sent him to do in the land of Egypt to Pharaoh, and to all his servants, and to all his land. None like him in all the signs and all the wonders which the Lord sent him to do, unequal for all the signal acts sent him to display in the land of Egypt against Pharaoh and all his courtiers and all his court. Against Pharaoh, signs and wonders, and against this whole country, bam! And in all that mighty hand, and in all the great terror which Moses showed in the sight of all Israel, body of Christ, which Moses wrought, and for all the mighty power and all the great and terrible deeds which Moses wrought in the sight of all Israel, how mighty the hand and great the fear that Moses wielded in the sight of all Israel. Hallelujah! Breakthrough, revival! Bam!